Make sure no one in the house is on the internet either. You want it all to yourself. Send the kids out. Don't let them be watching YouTube.
Here's an item which used to be in almost every household and which can give you music, news, and entertainment for free 24 hours a day with no internet connection required, no cell phone connection required, all in this wooden box about the size of a large shoebox. It's called a table radio. This one is a Magnavox. I found this at Goodwill. Paid $25 for it, which is pretty high for something like this, but it's in such good condition I couldn't resist. And I love the styling of the wood grain cabinet, the lighted tuning dial, the red LED clock, and the chrome accents and dials on the front panel. It really has a classy appearance. Not to mention very good sound quality and reception. Did not need any restoration work. The buttons and knobs were a little bit scratchy when I first started using it, but just using it more pretty much cleared up any problems with it. So I did not need to spray any deoxit into the volume control. It's a little bit crackly, but not too bad.
From her forthcoming album, Noyau. And her tune, which will play in just a few seconds, is entitled Igbo Landing.
Without us really identifying that right away. And we are really at the beginning in this country, discovering the ingredients that we have to cook with. And I...
There you go, a cooking show. All free on radio, no subscription required. Yes, sometimes you have to listen to commercials, but what doesn't have commercials these days?
And for our own nourishment.
Alice, when you think about organic today, it's everywhere. It's actually a huge value add for businesses to use that term.
Really good sound quality on this too.
It's everywhere. You can go to Costco and Walmart and Target and buy organic gummy bears and organic salads.
Here at the Garden, 6:15 to go first quarter. Knicks trail Detroit 12-10. Knicks fans, make sure to tune in.
There you get sports for free, including the Yankees, without needing to pay for the YES Network on your TV.
I'm being nudged to move faster, but I can't. The history of this union alone, we...
And you get music not only on FM, but also on AM.
In Hamilton, the CHML News Cruiser is there on the scene.
Researchers at McMaster University have developed a tool which can help determine how the virus that causes COVID-19 is.
When I came home here, I couldn't wait to get home. The air smelled different. The food was different. The land felt different. I've seen so many movies where somebody's away and they come home and kiss the ground because it's here. Lucky to be in this country. We're lucky that we get to choose our leaders, even though they, they're a sorry bunch.
So I set the alarm and I switched to wake to music, so at exactly 8 o'clock the alarm should turn on the radio. So there you go, the alarm clock works. Another interesting feature of this clock is the automatic dimming. There's this light sensor on the front panel here, and if I cover it up, you can see it dims it. So in the dark, it's not so bright.
Finance Minister Bill Morneau has said the government will be able to help businesses through any COVID-19 challenges. He says the budget will help with immediate health issues while trying to decrease the federal debt. This is the Canadian Press. In sports, at the Canadian Men's Curling Championship, Alberta taking on Newfoundland.
You can even get news from Canada.
News next at 9 on Global News Radio 900 CHML.
Coast to coast in Canada, across North America, and around the globe on the World Wide Web. This is Raceline on the Raceline Radio Network, presented by Subaru.
When you think about innovation these days, what kind of image comes to mind? Maybe a massive computer science lab, or a well-funded medical device workshop, or a flavor profile laboratory run by a gigantic food company? All true enough, but those are just the most visible sites of the innovation chain, the kind of photos you see in IPO slide decks for so-called cutting-edge companies. They are just the tip of the iceberg. Beneath that gleaming peak lie millions of underfunded, underappreciated home innovators.
So hopefully that's a good sampling of the different types of music, news, sports, and information and entertainment you can find on radio.
I invented a product called the Rinse-a-Roo. I originally was home at my beach house with messy showers and messy dogs, and I was bucket rinsing my showers and my dogs, and I thought there's got to be a better way.
I developed something for children to easily color eggs at Easter time. I designed a 3D printed prototype, and we love it, and it works great.
You may ask, what's inside this magic wooden box? What makes it work? Well, I'm going to take off the back and show you. And luckily, it's a lot easier than taking off the back of your smartphone. It's the Magnavox R436. This looks like a date code. I'm guessing the 9 is 1979. That's my best guess as of when this was made, judging by its styling and features. Made in Japan. There's inputs for an external FM antenna, or you can use this little wire to use the power cord as the antenna. There you go. So we have the power supply, the speaker, the light bulb for the radio dial, the radio tuner and clock circuit board. There's the potentiometers for the volume control and tone control. There's internal AM loopstick antenna, and this wire goes to the FM antenna. There you can see the dial pointer for the radio tuning dial, which moves back and forth as I tune the radio. Actually runs on a little string. The part that actually does the tuning is this box here. It's a variable capacitor. The speaker has an impedance of 8 ohms, nominal 2 watts, maximum 3 watts power rating, and I'm guessing that's also a 1979 date code. I know a couple years ago there was a lot of talk about analog FM radio being shut down, but so far the only country where that has actually happened is Norway. And ironically, I just looked up an article about it on the internet, and before I even got a chance to read it, an ad popped up on the screen asking me to pay $3.75 a week for access to the website. That's one thing you definitely won't get while listening to the radio. So hopefully this video just makes you stop and think a little bit about how wonderful of an invention radio really is, and how useful it still is after all these years, despite people underappreciating it and thinking that it has been completely replaced by online media. Well, at least for me, it definitely has not been.